Thank you. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In the waters of baptism, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Diane died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
Please join in singing number 539, Here I Am, Lord.
I will tell the Lord I pray.
Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Diane, whom you have called to journey to you, and since she hoped and believed in you, grant that she may be led to our true homeland, to delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated as we listen to God's word.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the righteous are in the hands of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction. And they are going forth from us, utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if to others indeed they seem punished, yet it is their hope full of immortality. Chastened by little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. As sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the God, word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, Lord,
from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be unaware, brothers, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with the word of the command, and the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with those words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. On behalf of St. Boniface Parish and the entire Archangel's Cluster, I want to extend my condolences to Rose and to Steve, to Stacy and Brian, James and Christy, and all the friends and family of Diane. From what I have been told, Diane was a very caring person, willing to help a neighbor in need, and the most compassionate person you could have ever met. She took, in some sense, those words of what we will hear tomorrow as well, repent and believe in the gospel of compassion, a gospel message that continually showed forth the mercy of our Lord. Tomorrow we will begin Lent with Ash Wednesday, and at the distribution of ashes, the minister will say one of the two options, and I mentioned one already, and the other option is, remember you are dust, and unto dust you shall return, reminding the penitent of our mortality. We never know when that day will come. In some sense, it can come very quickly and unexpectedly, or it can be, at times, a long process. We never know which way it will go or when that day will come. We can only prepare ourselves for that day during our life. We live in a world that says there are certain things that are unforgivable, but that is not the gospel we teach. That is not the gospel Diane believed in. We teach a gospel of forgiveness, commending those who go before us to the Lord, praying for them and asking God to show them his mercy. In the prayer over the offerings, it says, "We beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior may find in him a merciful judge." In this funeral mass, we do the most important thing we can do. We pray and lift our sister up to the Lord who desires mercy, not sacrifice. Our first reading speaks of those who have passed away, and in the sight of the world, it seems a tragedy. But we who have faith, while we still mourn, we have hope in the resurrection, that our loved one, Diane, will be brought to the joys of the eternal kingdom. It says, "Grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect." We pray that God may extend his love to Diane and make her one of the elect. We know that she imitated the Lord in his love and compassion by extending her hand to those who were in need, by going out of her way to show compassion and care and concern for those who were in need. Our second reading was from the letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. St. Paul is encouraging the Thessalonians in the hope of that we have in the resurrection, that those who have fallen asleep will be brought to life in him. We are encouraged to live in a way that we are accepting of the call that has been given to us by God in our baptism, to put off the old ways and to allow Christ to enter into our hearts, that encourage us to go out and serve one another in him. He tells us to encourage one another with the words of the resurrection and eternal life in the Lord, that we should not mourn in the same way that the world mourns, because they have no hope in eternal life. But we who believe in Christ are called to hope in him who has set us free and who has risen from the dead. We are called to encourage one another to have hope that we will be reunited with our sister Diane, who has gone before us in Christ. Finally, in the gospel, Jesus tells us to come to him, to allow him to relieve the burdens that we have and to rest in him. Jesus wants us to come to him, to lay our burdens down at his feet. God has hidden himself in the world, that those who are willing to trust in him might find him and surrender to him the things that burden them. Our human weakness can at times lead us to sin, but the mercy of God can wipe away that sin. We simply need to come to him in simplicity of heart. That is our hope, that in her heart, Diane came to the Lord and sought his compassion as she so readily gave it to others, that she believed in him and tried to follow after his example. May we continue to pray for Diane, that the Lord might grant her a place with him in his everlasting kingdom. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Stand. God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people.
for Diane, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she now be admitted to the company of the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Diane was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Diane, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord of compassion and the giver of consolation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our departed relatives and friends, we pray especially for Diane's parents, James and Ella, and her cousins, Steve and Rob, that they may welcome her with Christ into their everlasting home in the kingdom of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for Diane, strengthen our hope so that we may live in expectation of your son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for Diane and all our departed brothers and sisters. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the heavenly kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated as we prepare the altar.
Please join in singing number 614, Amazing Grace, verses 1, 2, 4, and 5.
Who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
His wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Diane, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
With you, the power and the glory are yours now
forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but I am not worthy that you should enter into my room. but only say the word, and my soul shall be guilty. For those who are not receiving communion, you can either remain in your pew, or you can come forward with your arms crossed and receive a blessing. We'll start with the south side of the church.
Maria. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Diane may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The burial will take place at a later date, and so everybody who is invited downstairs to a luncheon immediately following the conclusion of Mass. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Diane, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Diane again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Number 606 on Eagle's Wings.
Lord.